Welcome back. You have a bunch of trading ideas that we gave you in Super 6 Sand from Sudarshan. Now two more experts join us to tell us how to negotiate the trading day. Mayuresh Joshi of Angel Broking and Amit Gupta of ICICI Direct join us. Good morning to both of you gentlemen. Amit, first your strategy on the Nifty. It's likely to open gap up, maybe 100 points up, maybe close to 7,800. What would you do?
See Lata, actually we have seen a very aggressive put writing case in this market, even in the falling market. When Nifty was at 7750 levels, the 7400 put option premium was around 125 rupees. And when Nifty came down to 7540 and made a low, that time the premium of the same put strike of 7400 was 118. So in the last 200 points of decline from 7750, the put premiums have not increased. This is the same pattern what we saw when Nifty was forming the bottom before around 8000 levels, and then we saw around 500 to 600 points of surge in the market. So I think that kind of scenario may again come out. And now the volatility has not increased. From 30% it has come down to 25%. That is one of the reason why the premiums have not increased. But if you look at the open interest additions at 7400 put and 7500 put, I think it is very much possible that in this particular series these levels may not be taken out now again. And that is why we are selling 75 put option now. For our clients also we have recommended this. Around 80-85 rupees you can sell this option. It is possible that you will get most of the premium now in your pocket if you are adding this strike. FII's activities is still on the selling side, but somehow these are the trading bounces which are coming in the oversold market. So it is possible you can see the levels of 8000 also on the higher side.
Okay, well actually the markets have begun to give us the pre-opening rates, and it's not all that monster a rally at this point in time. Pre-opening rates have been relatively calm, but look at the rupee, that's shown a much smarter bounce. 66.53 was where it closed. The dollar is now about 16-17 pice cheaper than where it was. So remember, 66.86 was the low it had touched, the rupee that is, and exporters who chose to sell at that point would be sitting on a lot of gains for sure. So 66.75-80 is proving to be a very big support for the rupee and resistance for the dollar. At this point in time, a good 50 pice from those levels for the rupee. So rupee is showing a strong indication, and now the Nifty is showing more verve. It's a 1% gain, and 7770 has been scaled. That's a 1% gain. Sensex a little more said it, but still 0.75% higher. I don't know whether it's as yet time to read out the rates to you. As Varinder was pointing out, it would be led by the metals because there has been a big rally both on the LME and on metal stocks like BHP Billiton and Rio Tinto and Vale all over the world. And so Tata Steel leads the pack with a 5% uptick, closely followed by Cane with a 3% uptick. And then come the rest, the HCL Techs, the Vedantas, of course. I forgot about that metal stock. But we'll read those rates in just a bit. Mayuresh, good morning to you. What are you all telling your clients at this stage as well, to come in and put money? Or do you think that after seeing the kind of cuts, we are going to get better levels? One doesn't have to jump in.
Morning, Lata. I think clearly the uncertainty will still linger around, specifically related to how Chinese data pans out, what FOMC does. And I think the way Indian corporation batted for a rate cut, it is just around the corner. But the quantum of rate cut is something that the markets would be more inclined with, along with the commentary that the RBI gives, for a sustained cut cycle to continue in the next few quarters.
Okay.
All right. So clearly, just hold on to that thought, Mayuresh. We'll just come back to you in a bit. Now the pre-opening rates are stabilizing, and it looks like it's going to be a good day today. At least the start will look good. The Nifty is up about 100 odd points, and the Sensex is up about 250 points, led by the metals and the banking stocks. But just to, you know, alert the viewer that yesterday in the metal names we didn't see any delivery based buying. It was just a trading bounce that we saw. So for example, in Tata Steel, the delivery quantity was at 20 lakh shares was less than what we do on a 10-day average, and even in Vedanta the delivery quantity was very, very low. So just keep an eye out, this could just be a trading bounce. But yes, in some of the private sector banks like Yes Bank, ICICI Bank, we did see genuine delivery based buying. So those are stocks to look at. In fact, Amit, you have a couple of trading ideas for us. Take us through your view on HDFC Bank, and also are there any other private sector banks that are worth buying now?
See, HDFC Bank has remained the leader. I mean, if you look at this particular fall, it halted around 1000 levels. Now, these were the same levels where Nifty had previously found the bottom around 8000. But if you look at the other stocks, they have breached those levels because Nifty has also come down by 450 to 500 points below 8000. But this has remained quite, you know, around 8000 levels. And if you see the put options base, that has been the highest at 8000. And it is almost, you know, close above, just very close to 1000 levels. So I think there is some rally expected in the stock, and it is possible to move towards 1040. And there was a very you know, popular trade in the market wherever the FIs were favorite stocks are there, just go short in them because FIs have been selling in the market, and that is why the people, you know, they took some heart and shorted this stock, but they did not see that kind of price damage. And that is why I think once the market has come back in some momentum, you will see some kind of short covering panning out in this stock to of another 40 to 45 rupees. So we will go long. Or the another option is we will write the 1000 put option in this particular stock.
Heartwarming to see an ICICI guy saying that HDFC Bank is one of the better stocks to buy at this point. But of course, that's a technical call coming from Amit Gupta. Well, Mayuresh, sorry, we had a problem with the audio. What were you saying? You would ask your investors to put in, say, 20%, 30% right now, or hold back for lower levels?
As I was mentioning, Lata, I think the uncertainty would still linger on at least for the next few weeks, to say the least. And what FOMC does and what RBI does in terms of the quantum of rate cuts will be a key monitorable. Having said that, I think we feel that private sector banks on declines are a very good opportunity. I think the kind of earnings growth that they can exhibit over the next few quarters can be quite stupendous. And clearly looking at all the key parameters that one clearly looks at from a banking perspective, whether that be related to asset quality, capital adequacy, whether that be related to their branch network, fee income, non-fee income, I think all these parameters are probably surpassed by the private guys. So clearly I think private sector is something we like. The top tier IT companies is something we continue to like. Our own take is that the kind of client mining that a lot of these top tier names have done, I think will lead to significant amount of increase in revenues both in dollar and rupee terms. And though I think the rupee depreciation acts as a tailwind, a lot of the companies including Infosys have got headroom in terms of utilization rates going up close to 300 pips in our opinion. And clearly I think even in the case of TCS, I think the kind of digital foray, the kind of mining that it is doing is going to aid the company going forward. So TCS, Infosys, HCL Tech is something that we continue to like, and also selective pharma names. I think though valuations for the pharma sector generally are a little bit stretched, I think selective names like Sun Pharma, where we believe I think a lot in terms of how the RANVAX integration will go through, has probably come through in the price. The volume growth can be quite stupendous at 517 onwards. And similarly in the case of Aurobindo Pharma, the key approvals that the company has received, the injectables business, the ARV portion that Aurobindo Pharma caters to, our own take is that a top line growth of 12-13% over the next 2 years is not ruled out.
Okay, so you spoke about a lot of sectors, banks, IT and pharma, but what about some of these mid-cap auto ancillary names, Mayuresh? Are there any stock ideas over there that would interest you? Because we've seen a fair amount of correction in names like Motherson Sumi, Bharat Forge, etc.
So clearly, Sonny, I think I'll still wait and watch. Specifically in the case of Motherson Sumi, I think the results were a little bit disappointing in my opinion. Yes, it has got a very decent order book as far as its overseas business is concerned, specifically with SMR, SMP. But clearly, I think one really needs to understand how the new plants, product, capex is going to pan out, and that will have a definite impact on how cash flows will pan out. Clearly, on the domestic side as well, you've seen the falling copper prices clearly having some amount of impact, the cross-currency volatility creating some amount of jerks when it came specifically on the EBITDA front. But clearly, I think on declines is something that I look at Motherson Sumi, but not at the current level. But within the auto space generally, I think tire stocks on declines is something that I'll still continue to prefer. I think JK Tires, where our belief is that the structural story is still on, raw material prices have come down significantly, the ROE should sustain, and clearly I think the expansions that JK Tire is undergoing along with its Mexican subsidiaries contributing significantly better than it did a few quarters back, I think that would hold JK Tires up as well.
Okay, so now it is 7,800. Remember, these are bid rates, they are not yet traded rates, it's pre-opening. But 7,805 was what the Nifty has managed, and that's a good 1.5% higher. I will come to Mayuresh for more ideas, but just to finish your trading strategies, you have one on call, a sell on Colgate and a buy on L&T, Amit.
Yeah, because if you see the, you know, some profitable trades in the market are getting closed. We saw that in the last 200 points of fall in the market, when we saw the profit booking in the pharma space, and also in yesterday's session it was the FMCG pack. Now when the heavyweights are under pressure, because when the Nifty was surging, we didn't see that kind of move in ITC or Hindustan Unilever, and that is why the other stocks were under pressure. Now Colgate, since the last quarterly results, because the sales growth did not pick up that much what the market was expecting, so we have seen that there has been a continuous liquidation of long positions. Now 125% of long positions were built up in the last 4 or 5 months when the stock was trading around 950 levels. But when it came, started coming down and did not perform, the continuous liquidation is there, and already 40% of closer we have seen out of those positions. And yesterday it was down till 1800. I think 1700 kind of levels can still be seen in this particular stock. So if you are looking for some shorting opportunity, these may be some names where you possibly you can go short. Now when I talk about the short covering pattern, now that is clearly seen in L&T. Yesterday also there was 1 to 2% of closure of positions, and it has now, the one particular feature is, if you look at the fall from 1600 to 1500, the 1600 put writers, they did not close their positions at all. The open interest did not see the closure. Around 1000 contracts were there in 1600 put strike, and we did not see any closure in the 100 points of fall. And now once the when the stock is around 1560 1565, which is now the in the money strike of 1600 put is the highest, so that is why I think it should take out 1600 strike or levels on the higher side and should move towards 1650 1670. The as I said, the future open interest is already getting closed. Now people were going short in L&T little bit in the last breakdown level of below the breakdown level of 1750 because of the lower crude prices, also because the people, they felt of the lesser order book from the Middle East because of this reason. Now that is why I think the open interest of around 60-70% has piled up in this in future segment, which some of which may get close in this particular momentum of the market.
Okay, fair enough. Amit, thanks for joining us and giving us all your trading ideas. Well, the market in pre-opening has settled much higher, so the indication is that the start will be on the upside. 7800 is here on the Nifty, and the mid-cap index too is indicating that it could be a good start. Metal stocks are on top of the list. Mayuresh, how do you approach a stock like Tata Steel now? It's down 40% this year already, but now there are some contrarian views or positive views coming in on the metal space. Would you advise either trading or an investment call on this stock?
So clearly, Sonia, I think from a trading perspective, the stock might move up, as you rightly said. It has corrected significantly from levels that we'd seen earlier. But clearly, I think I'll still wait for numbers to come through, and the commodity cycle that we're still witnessing is giving no indication that improvement will happen either in terms of core realizations coming through domestically, which also apparently faces issues of the high iron ore inventory of almost 1.5 MTPA. And clearly, even on the European side of operations, I think realizations will take a hit. The Southeast Asian operations are going to take a huge amount of hit with a lot of dumping coming through in China and Russia. So it's a known fact, again, clearly, in how the leverage on the balance sheet of Tata Steel is playing, realization remaining soft. But clearly, I think I don't mind missing a rally on this stock even fundamentally. I'll wait for declines because I don't believe and see that the cash flows for this company will improve at least for the next 2 to 3 quarters.
What will be your top 3 Nifty picks now and your top 3 mid-cap picks from Angel?
So Lata, clearly, I think as I mentioned earlier, Axis Bank, ICICI Bank is something that we like from the private banking space. Infosys from the IT space is something that we continue to prefer. Power Grid from the power space is something that we believe can have a huge potential going forward. I think the stock has corrected significantly from the levels we'd seen earlier, and clearly with kind of capital outlay both in terms of core capex and the capital work in progress that Power Grid has up its sleeve over the next couple of years in excess of 1 lakh crore, I think that will ensure that the return on equity of 15.5%, which is again regulated, should get maintained. So at around 1-3 times price to book, we believe it's very, very attractive, at least from the top tier names. When it comes to the mid-cap space, Transport Corporation is something that we've always liked. After the sharp fall we've seen, our belief is that the two key segments, the XPS and the supply chain solutions, should contribute meaningfully, which have higher EBITDA margins as well. There's an additional capex of 500 odd crores going into these segments as well, which should ensure that the market share goes from 56 to 61% in the overall pie, and the EBITDA margins would expand from 8 to 9%. It's got a very light asset model, asset turnover ratios of 4.8 times, ROE is in excess of 13%. So it's a very attractive accumulate at this point of time at 11.5 times. Inox Wind is something that I've continued to like. Strong order book, again, the kind of capex that the company is making is going to ensure that the margins expand going forward. Our own take is that the top line growth should expand at a rate of 48% CAGR on the next 2 years. And clearly, looking at the kind of margin expansion, I think the bottom line will also see significant amount of growth. The third stock that I've liked for a length of time is Bajaj Electricals. Clear turnaround on the ENP side. And if you look at the overall EBIT performance, ENP has been a sharp turnaround over the last quarter. And the consolidated performance in terms of the LED and the consumer durable business, along with the decent order book that it possesses on these segments, I think that should hold that in good stead. So I think a clear turnaround story in case of Bajaj Electricals, and valuation on an EV to sales basis also look very, very attractive at this point of time.
All right, that's three mid-cap stocks you've spoken to us about: Inox, Transport Corporation, Bajaj Electricals. Any specific disclosures, Mayuresh?
Lata, clearly, I think all the stocks that we've discussed, I do not have any personal holdings, but we clearly might have discussed all these stocks with our clients.
All right, thank you very much. Have a great trading day, Mayuresh. We are just about 30 seconds for the markets to open, and it looks like it's going to be green all over, 1.5% gain, irrespective of which index you pick up. Yeah. And the Bank Nifty at the moment holding a slight edge with a 1.9% uptick. So looks like it's going to be a very great start.